Okay, children, let me continue. Already we have seen covalent bond. Next, ionic bond, covalent bond, and coordinate covalent bond. Now we have to see, because of the formation, what are the reactions happen? That is oxidation. Either the oxygen may be increased, reduction, hydrogen may be increased, and both are, some of the actions, both are simultaneously occur together. That is redox reaction. We have to see what is oxidation, what is reduction, what is redox reaction. So let me continue. Every reaction, certainly what should be there? Either the reaction may be oxidative reaction or reduction reaction. Now we have to see oxidation, reduction. Oxidation, it is the chemical reaction which involves addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen. Either oxygen may be added or hydrogen may be removed. So reduction, opposite reaction, addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen. And how to find out whether either it is oxidation or reduction? We can see removal of electron, loss of electron. It is loss of electron means this is gain of electron. Okay, so oxidation, every reaction, that reaction should exhibit either oxidation or reduction. So oxidation means what? Oxygen is present, addition of oxygen or removal of hydrogen. So one and the reaction oxygen adhigama irundirukkanum, adhila hydrogen remove irundirukkanum. Or else just easy understand, because we are talking about electrons only. Loss of electron means that is oxidation reaction. Gain of electron means that is reduction reaction. In some of the thing, both will occur simultaneously. ஒரு பக்கம் ஆக்சிடேஷன் நடக்கும், இன்னொரு பக்கம் ரிடக்ஷன் நடக்கும். போத் அக்கர் டுகெதர், தட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ரிடக்ஷன் இஸ் நோன் அஸ் ரெடாக்ஸ். தட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் ரியாக்ஷன் இஸ் நோன் அஸ் ரெடாக்ஸ் ரியாக்ஷன். தட் இஸ் ரிமூவ் ரெடியூஸ் அஸ் வெல் அஸ் ஆக்சிடேஷன், ரெடாக்ஸ் ரியாக்ஷன். போத் வில் அக்கர் சைமல்டேனியஸ்லி. கிளியர்? ஐ வில் கோ ஃபார் த கிளியர் டெஃபினேஷன் ஆஃப் ஆக்சிடேஷன். The chemical reaction which involves addition of oxygen, removal of hydrogen or loss of electron is called oxidation. Reduction, addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen, gain of electron. Both together, this is known as what? Examples are given, they say. Redox reaction, both together it occurs. Generally, the oxidation and reaction occurs in the same reaction simultaneously. If one of the reactants oxidized, other get reduced. Such reaction is known as oxidation. For example, you see, reduction reaction, we have seen the example. 2PbO, that is P means lead, lead oxide. Two molecule of lead oxide combined with one molecule of carbon and it becomes two molecule of lead and oxygen combined with thing and become carbon dioxide. Here, what is increased? Carbon dioxide is increased. And here, another example, zinc plus copper sulfate gives copper plus zinc sulfate. Here we say simultaneously, for example, this is reactant, that is product. So before the experiment, before the reaction started, that is what? Reactant. Arrow mark front la irukkiradhu reactant, arrow mark ku appuram varudhu product. Here how many oxygen there? Two oxygen. Here one carbon. After the reaction, this is removal of oxygen. Oxygen is increased here. This is oxidation. Okay, we are, because here two oxygen atoms are there, but here oxygen is reduced. So this is known as what? This is reduction. Clear? Here two oxygen along with the lead oxide. Rendu oxygen molecule atom irukku namakku. So this is oxidation reaction. So product la paaka poninga enna sonna lead is reduced into lead oxide is reduced into lead. Oxygen is combined with the carbon. So inga oxygen enna irukku ungalku reduce a irukku. So both oxidation and reduction simultaneously occur. This is known as redox reaction. Clear children? Now what are the thing I said already? Then there is some agents to support this oxidation and reduction. Certain element they will support oxidation and reduction. Those elements are known as oxidizing agent and reducing agent. Oxidizing and reducing. Substance which have the ability to oxidize other substance are called oxidizing agent. So எந்த ஒரு element oxygen அதிகமாக இன்னொரு element கொடுக்குதோ அது oxidizing agent. For example, what are the oxidizing agent? H2O2, that is hydrogen peroxide, MnO4, manganate, CrO3, chromium, chromate, Cr2O7, dichromate. So let me write again, because you must know the chemicals. No, I'll write here. What are the oxidizing agent? H2O2, hydrogen peroxide. Okay, MnO4, manganate, CrO3, chromate. This and all what? Chemicals. Cr2O7. CR2, dichromate. Single arc mode chromate solru, adhe 2 means di what? Dichromate. Okay, the same like reduction reaction, reducing substances which have the ability to reduce other substance are called reducing agent. Some of the common reducing agent are, that is sodium bromide, NaBH4. Sodium bromate, lithium aluminate and metals like platinum and palladium and platinum. These are the examples for reducing reaction. Oxidation reaction in our daily life, how it is useful to us. The nature of oxygen present in the atmospheric air oxidizes many things, starting from metals to living streams, for everything, living tissue. Oxidizing is very important. We too need oxygen for our breathing purposes. What are the thing? What are the uses? The shining surface of the metal tarnishes due to the formation of respective metal oxides on their surface. This is called corrosion. Corrosion, you know, for example, silver article and all. That is silver, when it is exposed to air, silver, that is silver Ag. Silver formula is Ag. When it is exposed to air, that is oxygen from the air involves in that and become silver oxide. Because of the silver oxide, because of the formation of oxygen, before that it was very shining. Now the shining is reduced and it's known as what? Corrosion. Adha enna solra namba? Corrosion. Even iron. Iron means what? Irumbu, Fe. Adhu kuda neenga konja naal appadi open la vechirundinga, it becomes what? Ferrous oxide. Irumbu vandu thurupidikkirudhu nu solringa, that is rusting. FeO2. So totally, because metals are corroded with oxygen, it is known as corrosion. Clear? The freshly cut surfaces of vegetables and fruits turn brown after some time because of oxidation. For example, apple, whatever the fruits may be, if you cut and keep, immediately you are taking means okay. So after half an hour will take, if you cut and store half an hour, you will eat it and eat it. Apple changes into a reddish brown color because this is what? Oxidized. Because you kept open, oxygen in all the places, air will be there. Nama empty place nanicha kuda anga kandipa enna irukum ungalku air. This air, from the air oxygen reacts with it and changes the color of the fruit. Oxidation reaction food material they were left open for a long period is responsible for spoiling the food. Whatever it may be, if you have kept the food in the open condition or cut the fruit in open condition for a long time, it will spoil. Though oxidation is very important to us, at the same time it's dangerous also. So immediately you have to take the food or you have to eat the fruits whenever it cuts. This is called rancidity. Okay, that is long period it exposes and spoils the food. For example, fish and all we are keeping in the fridge. அதே ஃபிஷ்ஷை நீங்கள் வெளியே போட்டிங்கன்னா வித்தின் த டே வி ஹவ் டு யூஸ். ஸோ டூ டேஸ்க்கு அப்புறம் யூஸ் பண்ணலாம் அப்படிலாம் இருந்தீங்கன்னா ஃப்ரிட்ஜ் ஒன்லி வி ஹவ் டு கீப் அண்ட் ஃப்ரிட்ஜ். நத்திங் ஷுட் பி கீப் டு ஓப்பன். கிளியர் சில்ட்ரன்? அப்படி ஓப்பன் பண்ணியிருந்தால் இட் வில் பி அஃபெக்டட் பை ஆக்சிடேஷன் அண்ட் சம் அதர் பேக்டீரியாஸ் அண்ட் தட் ப்ராசஸ் இஸ் நோன் அஸ் ரான்சிடிட்டி. தென் ஆக்சிடேஷன் நம்பர், ஏதோ த ஆக்சிஜன் இஸ் இன்க்ரீஸ்ட் ஆர் டிக்ரீஸ்ட், திஸ் கேன் பி ஃபவுண்ட் அவுட் பை ஆக்சிடேஷன் நம்பர். தர் இஸ் அ ப்ராப்ளம், சம் ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் ஆர் கிவன் டு யூ, வில் அட்லீஸ்ட் We'll do out of 2 or 3 problems. Whatever possible, we'll try now. Clear? Oxidation. How to find out the oxidation number? For example, what is given there? Water. What are the things there? Hydrogen and oxygen. Two elements are combined together. One is hydrogen. How many hydrogen there? 2 hydrogen, oxygen. H2O, clear? 2H and O. So we can assume like this. So by substituting both, answer will be what? 0. We'll say no. Hydrogen is plus 1. Oxygen is, one we have to consider as 1, other one we have to consider as 2. One is plus means other one is what? Minus. H1, hydrogen value is what? 1. That is positive charge. Then oxygen value is 2, that is negative charge. Now how many hydrogen there? 2 into 1 is equal to 2 into 1, 2. Here hydrogen what? Oxygen. This is hydrogen. Oxygen is plus 2 into, oxygen is what? Minus 2. This is hydrogen plus 2. Oxygen minus 2. Answer will be 0. Clear children? This is O, oxygen. Not 0. So hydrogen 2 atom, that is plus 2. Oxygen only 1, that is minus 2. Plus 2, minus 2, நீங்கள் cancel பண்ணான வரும் 0. Clear? So, we can say that oxidation, hydrogen is plus, oxidation number of hydrogen is 1, then oxidation number of oxygen is 2. The same like we have to go for H2SO4. H2SO4 means sulfuric acid. What it is? Sulfuric acid. How many hydrogen there? 2 hydrogen, 1 sulfur, plus 4 oxygen. Okay, the same like we have to take as hydrogen 1, 2 plus 1 hydrogen, then sulfur, oxygen 2 only as usual, oxygen 2. That is how many oxygen there? 4. So minus 2 into 4, minus 8. Here sulfur X, 2 into 1 plus 2, X minus 8. Plus 2 into X minus 8. Clear? Minus 8 is equal to 0. This is the equation. So, plus 2 into x, 2x. Minus 8. So, 8 minus 6 means x is equal to 8 minus 2, 6. X is equal to, that is sulfur is equal to 6. Oxidation number of sulfur is 6. Already we know the oxidation number of hydrogen and oxygen. We have to find out the oxidation number of sulfur. Like that every sum we have to go through. Clear? So mainly you just give importance to the book example. Even you are not go through the book example, at the back of the book it's given with the question and answers. Find out the oxidation number of. So totally how many there? Illustration 1, 2, 3, 4. 4. Apart from 4, back also something is given. Problems it's given for us. That is potassium permanganate, chromate and ferrosulfate. So we have to go through for all. Clear? And question and answers I'll give in another class, I said. Anyway, we'll see. Clear, children? Oxidation reduction lesson will be over. So as already in the for the half-yearly exam, we have given the answers in the last moment. So the management advises to give the answers then and there. So take your science textbook, take page number 159. At least we'll go for choose the correct answers. Okay. Objective types we'll see. First one, choose the correct answer. Number of valence electron in carbon is A2. Option B is the correct answer. B is 4. Option B is the correct answer. Next one, sodium having atomic number 11, it is ready to dash electron. So option C is correct, 1 electron. How many electrons it loses? 1 electron. Third one, the element that would form anion by gaining electron in a chemical reaction is fluorine. Option C is the correct answer. Fourth one, bond formed between a metal and non-metal atom is usually ionic bond. Option A is correct. Then compounds have high melting and boiling points, ionic bond. Option C is correct. Sixth one, covalent bond is formed by sharing of electron. Option B is correct. Seventh one, oxidizing agents are also called as electron acceptors. Elements with stable electronic configuration of 8 electrons in the valence shell, they are noble gases. Option C. Just go through. First one is B, second one is C, third one C, fourth one A, fifth one C, sixth one B, seventh one is B, and eighth one is C. We have to go for answer briefly. So let me give afterwards. We'll go through the points because you should be ready. So the next class we have to see question and answers only. So what are the things we come across so far? What is octet rule? What is chemical bond? What is octet rule? That is 8, the last orbit. How many electrons should be 8 electron? What is stable thing we have seen? Then after that, how the electron atoms are combined together? That is Lewis dot structure, the type of chemical bond. We have seen 3 type of chemical bond: ionic, covalent and coordinate. Apart from that, we can divide as strong bond and weak bond also. It's given in page number 151. It is a question at the back. What are the things come under strong bond? Ionic bond, covalent bond, coordinate bond and metallic bond. Metallic bond we have not studied about that too. Then weak bond is hydrogen bond and van der Waals interaction. These are weak bond. Then characteristics. So ionic bond and covalent bond, whatever the important points I said, you have to underline and make the, suppose they are giving the question to you, what are the differences between ionic and covalent? You have to take one point from this side, means other points equal to that. You have to give the correct substitution to that. Clear? And we have given the example for covalent bond, ionic bond and coordinate covalent bond. And I said how to make also, we have seen oxidation and reduction. Both occur simultaneously. This is known as what? Redox reaction. How to find out the oxidation number. Then what are the oxidation reaction in daily life? How it will be useful? Because the metals are pernicious because of what I said. Oxide react with the metal and it's known as corrosion. The fresh fruits while cutting, it will take some time to heat. Means the changes of it change the color of the fruits. This is because of oxidation. So if you are kept open for long time, it will known as spoiling the food. The spoiling food is otherwise scientifically known as rancidity. Clear, children? That's all. Nothing to explain. We'll go for the question and less question and answers in other class. Thank you.